Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? Let's continue through the constellation of Ophiuchus, adding to last week's targets of IC4665, 70 Ophiuchi, and Barnard's star. But instead of going outside the house shape, this week we'll stay inside that asterism. As with any house, let's begin at the foundation. Starting from the east, looking across the bottom of Ophiuchus finds the 2.5 magnitude stars Sabic and Zeta Ophiuchi, and then 3.2 and 2.7 magnitudes Yed Posterior and Yed Prior over on the western side. Capping off the top of the house are Kappa Ophiuchi, Rosalhag at the peak, and then Sebelrai, which is the star we started from last week. Let's look for a pair of globular clusters, starting with Messier 12. Magnified Finderscope users may wish to start at the cool red giant star Yed Prior, a 3,700 degrees Kelvin star that is 171 light years from Earth. This red giant has undergone significant expansion and is nearly 60 times the radius of our Sun. While physically large, it contains just 1.5 times the mass of our Sun. So it's a bit of a fluffy star, as its density is quite low compared to our host star. From here, a 7-degree hop in the direction of Kappa Ophiuchi finds Lambda Ophiuchi first, a 4th magnitude binary having just 1 arc second of separation. Try using an 8-inch scope or larger for splitting this tight pair. From there, it can be a bit of a challenge to hop the 5.5 degrees to the cluster, as there aren't many helpful stars pointing the way. The best way I've found is to use this 6.4 magnitude star, draw a line through Lambda, and continue on to the globular. But there's actually an easier way for Red Dot or Telrad Finder owners. More on that in a moment. And now this week's dark sky fact. In the United States alone, $2.2 billion goes to light up absolutely nothing, as misdirected and unshielded light escapes into the atmosphere and doesn't even light up the ground where the light would be needed. This is where drawing straight lines and finding intersections, just like in high school geometry, finally comes in handy. First, look at a line from Yed Posterior up to Sebelrai. It's quite a distance, a good 23 degrees of sky. Next, look from Zeta Ophiuchi to third magnitude Kappa. Then imagine where those lines intersect and point your finder there. In a long focal length eyepiece, Messier 12 should be visible. Good binoculars can also help track down this object, though it merely appears as a nebulous spot in them. Then increase the magnification for the best image size. With the brightest stars at magnitude 12, smaller telescopes may have difficulty resolving individual members, while larger telescopes of 6 to 10 inches or larger will finally resolve some of the cluster's brighter stars. Separated by just 3 degrees of sky is an apparent twin of Messier 12, although the two clusters do have some differences. With a magnified finder, locating Messier 10 is a simple matter of making a small hop southeast. Look for these two stars, a 6th and 7th magnitude pair, and moving a nearly similar distance that M12 is from them. In a 7 degrees field of view finder scope, you can see these two stars and a 5th magnitude star, 30 Ophiuchi. Messier 10 sits between these three, but a bit closer to 30. For zero power finder locating, draw two more lines in the sky and look for the intersection of Yed Posterior to Eta Serpentis, both third magnitude, and Zeta Ophiuchi and Rosalhag. Visually, the stellarium depictions are a bit deceiving, as I find Messier 10 to appear a bit brighter than Messier 12. The core appears brighter and more compact, thus seeming to be more visually appealing at the eyepiece. Messier 12 is slightly larger, but also looks a bit dimmer, and is not as perfectly spherical as M10 is. What differences do you see between these two globular clusters? Did you like this video? Please consider sharing with others on social media sites so we can show others what is visible in the night sky, and continue educating about light pollution, or by subscribing to this YouTube channel. For more information on amateur astronomy and stargazing, visit eyesonthesky.com. Thanks for watching. Keep your eyes in the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.